rock. Let me catch. You ready?
Let me bone.
Solomon, man, says
yo. Yo, what's up, back. Son?
What's up, kid?
What's going on, kid?
Yo, man, I'm just doing my thing, man.
Side, the New York Times side, staying alive was no job, at second hands, moms bounced on old men, so then we moved to Shaolin land, a young youth, you're rocking the gold tooth, low goose, only way I begin to G-York was drug loot, and let's start it like this son, rolling with this one, and that one, pulling out gats for fun, but it was just a dream for the team, who was a fiend, started smoking wools at 16, and running up in gates and doing hits for high stakes, making my way on fire. Skates. No question, I was speed for cracks and weed. The combination made my eyes bleed. No question, I would grow up and try to get the ball off. Sticking up right boys on ball board. My life got no better. Same damn low sweater. Times is rough and tough like leather. Figured out I went the wrong route. So I got with a sick tight clip and went all out. Catching keys from front seats, rolling in MPVs every week.
Okay, good morning, America. Another day, another dollar. Welcome to the Sparky Malarkey Show. SparkySkills@gmail.com. Sparky Malarkey Television, Spark Dog Entertainment, all that good stuff coming at you. A lot on the bill today. Starting with the Los Angeles Dodgers, Magic Johnson and Company. They signed Zach Greinke to a big deal. And when asked, when Magic Johnson was asked yesterday at the press conference, he said, money's no object to you, is it? He, Magic's great. he stood up. He said, I'm going to answer this guy's question real quick. He went over to the microphone. He didn't get in front of it. He said, we want to win. and right away, I mean, 2 seconds later, I thought of George Steinbrenner. I thought of all these people that always just say, oh, the Yankees buy championships. That's the goal. That's what we do in Major League Baseball. You buy players, and then you compete. If you go to the supermarket and buy a dollar steak, it's probably not going to taste as good as the $20 steak. So the Dodgers are spending money, and you got to respect it. And I'm jealous. We signed Kevin Youkilis, and they have the world. Okay, moving on. The Patriots kicked the snot out of the Texans the other night, which I knew was going to happen. Mark Flair knew it was going to happen. Listen, Tom Brady, Bill Belichick, and company, they know what they're doing. So if you don't implement a great plan of attack for the Sunday against the New England Patriots, you're going to be exposed and taken care of, dealt with, and that's it. It's 8/23/2012. What is it? Wednesday? Must be Wednesday morning. Okay, what else? Today's Wednesday or Tuesday? Today's Wednesday. Yeah, today's Wednesday. Okay, so what else is on the bill? Ray Lewis, I guess, is back. At least his presence is going to be back. That's good for the Ravens. They need to win one game out of their last three, which I think is doable. They have three tough games, but let's see. Who else? The Bengals. Let's see who they are. Tony Touch, he down with us. DJ Green Lantern, he down with us. Okay, so the Bengals have the Eagles.
They down with us. DJ Mr. C, he down with us.
DJ Evil D, he down with us.
So the Bengals have the Eagles. I guess that's Thursday night, because it says next game. Yeah, Thursday, December 13th. 8:20 at Lincoln Financial Field. Oh boy. Oh, it's all right here. Okay, so the Giants have Atlanta in Atlanta. Cincinnati's taking it to Philly. Denver's at Baltimore on the early game. Green Bay is playing Chicago. That's a great game. Good rivalry. Washington versus Cleveland. RG3 has a sprained knee. Minnesota has St. Louis, who cares? Peterson going for 2,000 yards on the ground. Jets, Tennessee. Frisco Pats in New England. Foxborough, that should be a good one. That's Sunday night at 8:20. Pittsburgh at Dallas. That should be a good one. Ben versus the kid. San Diego, Carolina, who cares? Buffalo, Seattle, who cares? Detroit, Arizona, okay. Tampa Bay, Saints in New Orleans. Okay, so that's the rundown. Basketball. Lakers lose. Kobe is frustrated in La La Land. A reporter last night asked him, he said, you know, we've always seen you get on your teammates, like in the locker room, really go nuts and let them have it, start screaming. And he started laughing. He said, but this year we really haven't seen you do that. And Kobe explained, he said, well, you know, I used to have a great coach that through hard times would stay calm and go and just stick to the X's and O's and get us through it. He said, so that's what I'm trying to do this year. He said, but man, these guys are really with me. And they started laughing. And the reporter started laughing. He said, they're really trying my patience though this year with this Zen stuff. It was funny. So then the reporter has the balls to ask him, he says, how frustrating is this? Kobe looks at him like he's an idiot. And he says, compared to 2005. And I thought Kobe was kind of calling him an idiot when he said that. Because, you know, comparing depression and nightmares. So he says, compared to 2005, what's the frustration like? No lie, people. I see Kobe's eyes swell up with tears. Red tears, swallows, lip quivering, and it didn't even matter what he said. I knew his answer. Extremely frustrated, folks. 8:28 a.m. It's the Sparky Malarkey Show, December 12th, 2012. Coming right back at you.